All-wheel drive muscle cars, a sold-out hypercar, a pretty new wagon, and some sad news from Mazda. I'm Jody Lai, I've lost my voice, and this is AutoGuide.com's weekly news roundup. The biggest and probably most controversial news this week is the announcement that the 2017 Dodge Challenger will now come with an all-wheel drive option. Called the Challenger GT, this is the first American muscle car to be offered with all-wheel drive, which is something we're sure a lot of people are up in arms about, yet are secretly thankful for, especially the ones who have to deal with winter weather. Under normal conditions, the power is just sent to the rear wheels, and then if the car detects that more traction is needed, then it engages the front axle. Unfortunately, it won't be offered with a manual or with a V8. A V6 and an 8-speed auto are the only options available. The all-wheel drive Challenger arrives in early 2017, with pricing in the US starting at just over $33,000. Also this week, Aston Martin confirmed that its hyper-expensive hypercar is already sold out. Although they never confirmed pricing, the AMRB001 is rumored to cost about $3 million, and all 150 street-legal ones have already been spoken for. The car, which is a collaboration between Aston Martin and Red Bull, is powered by a V12 that apparently outputs an insane 1,000 horsepower and can rev all the way to 11,000 RPM. Luckily, 25 track-only versions of the car are still up for grabs. In spy photo news, the upcoming Buick Regal wagon has been spied in the US completely undisguised. The car was spotted in California during a company photo shoot, and although it has an Opel badge, when it arrives here as a Buick, it's going to look pretty much exactly the same, which is great news because this is a legitimately pretty wagon. Too bad North Americans don't buy wagons anymore. We can expect more details about powertrain and performance when the Buick officially debuts in the Geneva Motor Show in March. And we got some bad news from Mazda this week. Unfortunately, they're not planning on building a sports car that's bigger than the Miata, which means that the RX-9 isn't coming anytime soon. When the beautiful RX Vision concept came out, it renewed hope in the Rotary faithful that the RX-9 would make a comeback. But Mazda's CEO this week basically put a stop to all those rumors and confirmed that this isn't happening. The good news is that Mazda is still researching a new rotary engine, but when and if it arrives, it likely won't be powering a sports car. And in some more bad news, the mayors of four major cities have vowed to outlaw diesel cars by 2025. Surely part of the fallout from the Volkswagen diesel scandal, Paris, Madrid, Athens, and Mexico City have all pledged to rid their cities of diesel cars in the next 9 years. Athens went even a step further, saying that it wants to rid the city of cars in general. The mayors said air pollution and health problems due to diesel engines are cause for concern. Don't forget to subscribe so you never miss one of our weekly news updates, and hopefully my voice will be better so I won't sound like this next week.